my massive hoodie on. I've got some pajamas on, Star Wars. It means it's the holidays. Heck yeah, I'm so excited. Hi everyone, it's Laura X Stitches here, or just Laura. Really excited to be back with my March update video. As you guys know, I've been moving into monthly videos due to work. I am a school teacher, as you can see, education graduate. First year out, and I am on my first holidays of the year. Term one is finished. We're going into term two just after Easter. Super excited to be on holidays. So tired. It's been a huge term, but I've loved it. As struggling, as tough, as challenging as it was, excuse my hair, it was really awesome. So today I'm got the house to myself. My boyfriend literally just left for work. It is Sunday. It's the 2nd of April. We've just gone into our daylight savings time. Off it. I don't remember which one it is, but we gained an hour. So whatever that one is, that happened. So it feels like a lot later than it actually is. So that's really cool. I've got two dogs over there. One's outside. So if there's barking or anything, I will do my best to stop the video, because I know with my dogs, if I'm watching a video and there's dogs barking, I have to pause it or turn it down because they'll start barking, and I don't want that to happen to you. So they might walk around a bit, they might come visit, who knows, and you'll probably hear some groaning and snoring. The other noise that you might be hearing is just over this side of me. My boyfriend has a 3D printer, and that is currently printing, and it sounds like a big fan. So, and there might be some weird noises with that, but hopefully it's not too loud. I'll just try and speak loud. And I'm really excited to have the house to myself because I can actually speak normal. I don't have to feel like I'm reserving myself for anyone. So, I've got some notes. I've got a lot to talk about today. I've done a bit, I've got a bit, I've planned a bit. It's exciting. So, life update. School, really awesome. Got 2 weeks off, stitching for 2 weeks. I've not actually worn any proper clothes yet. It's been 2 days. So we finished on Friday, and yesterday was Saturday, today is Sunday, and I'm in my pajamas. I have showered, so that's exciting, but I'm in my pajamas. I'm going to mum's for dinner tonight, so I will actually wear proper clothes, but it's holiday mode, guys. No need to look nice, so that's exciting. It's been a pretty interesting term. You saw me last at the end of February, which was about a month in, and since then it's been interesting. So I guess like the honeymoon period wore off of teaching, where it was like, oh, it's all like, yay, flowers and rainbows and stuff. It got really difficult after that, which is totally normal for first year out teachers. So I had parent teacher interviews at one point. I had to do some other interviewing with parents, which was fine. I've got really awesome parents and awesome kids. I have a really great class and the school is awesome. So that's really exciting. I just got a little bit doubty about myself. So if you don't know, I do have anxiety and some bits of depression every now and again that come in a lot. And with the weather changing, it's getting colder, as you can see by my gigantic hoodie, it is getting colder. So that changes my mood as well. And like PMS and stuff as well, but whatever. But I was getting very doubty about my abilities to teach. And so there was a week or so where I didn't actually stitch. And I did post about it on Stitchmania. And there was so many beautiful comments, which was so nice. But yeah, I got a little bit down about myself and about my teaching abilities. But I have a really awesome mentor in my school who is the deputy principal. He does a whole lot of stuff. And he came in and taught my class for a session it was meant to anyway, but it was just cool to see what he was doing, and it kind of reinvigorated myself. I've got a really awesome school and really great staff, so it's awesome. There was something else I was going to say. Oh, that's right. Another cool thing that happened was that last weekend I went on a little trip with all the girls in my family. So it was my grandma, my auntie, my mum, my sister, and my two out of three girl cousins. There was another one, she couldn't come, but, and me. So there's seven of us. We went to a beautiful place in Victoria, up in the beautiful foresty bush area with lots of wildlife and stuff. Not that we saw heaps, but it was around, but we didn't actually get to see much, which is all right because we're used to it, so it's fine. Saw a huge spider though, that's not fun. It was a beautiful weekend away. It was the three C's: cocktails, crafting, and chocolate, and that happened. And there was, so I was cross-stitching. There was cross-stitching and knitting pretty much that was happening. So I was cross-stitching. My auntie was cross-stitching. She had a really beautiful piece from New Zealand she was doing. My mum did a bit of both, but she mainly stuck to cross-stitching in the end because she's got a really sore wrist. So that's why that's happened. I was teaching my cousin how to cross-stitch, but then she went to knitting and she actually made a beanie in the time that we were there. So that was cool. My other cousin made this beautiful scarf, which was like really thick yarn with big needles. It's gorgeous. And my sister was finishing off this amazing jumper. If I can find a photo of this jumper, I'm going to put it in. If I can find it on the Instagram or something, but it's just gorgeous. So I'm going to pop it in if I can. If not, I'm sorry. It's got lots of cabling and stuff. It's gorgeous. We should move on because it's been 6 minutes. I will talk about that a bit later with haul and everything, but let's get on to whips. I've had a bunch of finishes, no fully finished objects as per usual, because I need to just sit down and do that. I'm going to assume when I move out into our new place, which we haven't even looked at yet, don't even know when that's happening, but we are doing it this year. From there, I'm going to do a bunch of framing and finishing and stuff. So the first thing, would be my March calendar piece. And I forgot to bring the actual thing with me, but I'm doing, if you don't know, the Adorable Animals calendar, which was from Cross Stitch Crazy magazine last year, at the end of last year. And each month I do a different one. Now I'm doing it a bit out of order for some of them because it's an English calendar and I'm in Australia. The seasons are different. So for instance, summer was meant to be January was meant to be a snowy dog, but I changed it to the August one, January, which was an octopus that was drinking and had sunglasses on and stuff because it's summer here in January. So I did March. This is March. It is on 14 count 80, which is very basic, which is the recommended DMC. Nothing's changed. Yeah, it's a cute bear holding some flowers, and I'm adding in just the dates at the bottom. They're not charted, but I've just found an alphabet online and just popping that in. That's March. Pretty easy. That didn't take me very long at all, so that was really exciting to get done. I have just finished April. Wasn't yesterday, the day before, so it would have been Friday when I got home from school for the holidays. April is this one for Easter. It's these adorable fat chicks. They're so cute. This one I kept the same, and March is also the same. I haven't moved that from another month. This is the same. Next month's is different to what is in there, but I'll show you that when I get to it. I decided to do, usually I do, like I did this one the first couple days of March, and usually I do this one the first, like I should be doing it now, but I wanted to do it before that because of another whip that I'll show you in a minute. I just wanted to get this out of the way. I actually ran out of the yellow and I was up to here. I had 3.5 stitches left. And I was like, I'm not going to Spotlight to get another skein, I don't know what it's called, of this for 3 stitches. So I found some offcuts and just very strugglingly, that's not a word, stitched it in. Thank goodness, because I was not going to go to the store to get 3.5 stitches worth. So that's done. So those two are my calendar pieces. They are done, and done. Last time you saw me, I had finished my Bothy Threads Love Tree, and I was moving on to my Pokemon piece, which I'll show you in a minute because it's my current whip. After I finished a page of that, I was going to do Luck Bears, which is this, by Soda Stitch. This was gifted to me by Adele Cat Stitches, or Adele. Love you, Adele. Oh my god, I sounded so like Valley Girl. Oh my god. So that was that. And there's some more. I've got Love Bears as well. She gave me that too. I was doing Luck Bears. She also gave me the Aida for this. It is just, I think it's 16 count blue Aida. And I finished it. It's all done. I love it. I haven't looked at this in about a week. So I was excited to see this again. This is, like I said, 16 count aider. It is just a blue color. I used all of the recommended threads. Nothing has changed. Yes, I'm gonna bring in closer for each letter because I'm quite happy with these. So here's L. I actually did it LCUK, but I'll show you it in the actual order. There's C. U with the butt. H the butt. And K. Now, I was aiming to do one of these letters a week. L, I think I did. Then I moved on to C. And C, I was doing on a public holiday. And I actually got this done in 2 days because I just stitched because I needed that break of stitching. Because after school, I only get like an hour in and I need some more. I think it was you. One of these ones is when I stopped stitching for that week due to anxiety and that kind of thing. I don't remember which one, but I did get this finished. Right near the end of March. So happy with that. I will be framing this, and I've decided that whenever I eventually have children, this is going to be in their nursery along with Love Bears. So I don't need to frame this for a while. I will frame it and hang it up somewhere before I have kids. But yeah, that's where it's going to go. I've got to do other stuff before I have kids anyway. Oh my goodness. Stick around for something to do with Luck Bears at the end, by the way. Okay, after Luck Bears, I did April. After April, I moved on to Pokemon. Now, I did say before that I was going to start Luck Bears after I had finished a page of Pokemon because, excuse me, taking the Q stuff off, because I only had a little bit left of page 3. I got that done. I got it done very quickly. So I'm going to try. I've wrapped this up in a weird way, but it works for me. But anyway. Here's where I'm at with Pokemon. So, last time, and I'll insert in picture, hopefully if I remember. Oh my goodness, this is really awkward. Last time, I was somewhere down here, I think. So I finished that page, which was halfway, pretty much halfway through this pink dude here. Yesterday, I picked this up again, and I did a column. So I went from here to here, up here to down here. So that this is page 4, and then there'll be page 5, and then that's the top row done. So it goes, there's 25 pages, so it's 5x5 pretty much. So super happy with that. Excuse this mess. Just don't even ask about it. It's a bit crazy with my threads at the moment, but that's fine. So I'll be working on this. That is another part of my plans, which I'll talk about in a moment after haul, but this is something that I'm going to be focusing on for the holidays. So I want to do as much as I can in the next 2 weeks that I have. I'm aiming to get the 2 pages finished, so page 4, which I'm on, and then page 5. I feel like I can do it because I've got a fair few days, and I haven't got anything planned for the holidays except for like 2 days. So, all I want to do is stitch because I don't get as much time during the week as I'd like. So that's what I'll be doing. So hopefully today, after this video, after it's edited and I'm uploading, I'll get back to this. So this is my current whip. And that's all I have for whips. It doesn't seem like much, but with the 2 calendar pieces and Luck Bears, I feel like I've done a fair bit in March. So I'm really happy with that. So there are my whips. And I'll talk you through my plans in a moment. I've got a bit of haul to get through first. So you can skip the haul if you don't want to see it to get to plans. That's fine, but I'm going to go through haul. I'm going to just randomly pick up things. This is in no particular order. It's going to be completely out of order because I just dumped it on my table. So I picked up a 6x6 Q-snap for Luck Bears. I only started using this at the K because I'm a mess. I had been using a hoop and I am now only using hoops for something like this. It just, like, as I do like hoops, like, don't get me wrong, but the tension is just so much better in this. I look really weird. I'm into it. Anyway, it's so much better in a Q-snap. I will say, because of the size of the aider with Luck Bears, because there wasn't much room here, it was kind of hard to get it tighter, but it was fine in the end. So, love that. I also had, it's all just behind you, so I'm going to like hug you to get everything. I purchased a while ago from JK's Cross-Stitch Supplies on Facebook. If you're in Australia, I highly recommend her. I've talked about her before, Janet. Really cheap skeins, really cheap DMC. It's like 75 cents, which is really cheap for in Australia compared to Spotlight and Linkcraft and things like that. And it's super quick postage. As soon as you pay, she sends it the next day or that day. And you get a needle minder, so it's awesome. I don't have any needle minders on Pokemon, I just realised, but it's the same one that's been in my last one, so if you're really curious, you can look at that. So I ordered this cone when I was doing my Warrior Princess, which if you remember is now my UFO, because she just had so much black and I wasn't going to go buy 4 billion skeins or skeins of black when this would be cheaper. So I bought this in like November and she had to back order. I didn't actually pay till she got it in, which was really cool. But she backordered from France and it finally arrived in February. And I don't remember if I showed this in my last video, but I wanted to show you now. So it's just a cone, DMC 310. It's the six strands in the thing. And that's going to last me 4,000 years because I've got so many skeins lying around anyway. But happy with that. Another thing that was actually purchased for me by my mum and my sister, they found these at a op shop or a thrift store. We call them op shops. Two of these, I'm only going to show you one. They're tapestry and embroidery frames, and they were $3 each. I've got two. Now, I don't know how these are different to normal frames. I haven't opened it, but hey, I thought I'd show you. They're Simcoe, which is it's a brand, I guess. I don't know what I'm going to put in here because they're quite large, but I'll figure out something. So I was happy to get those. It was $6 for two frames. I mean, I ain't gonna say no to that. It was a gift. Next thing, I'm going through this quickly because I'm already at 17 minutes and I haven't really gone on to the main bit yet. I have been really good with my Citroen stash. I'm very proud of myself because I guess I was lucky because I had all this birthday money, which I'll show you in a minute what I actually bought with that. I did talk about it last video, but it all arrived this month. So I want to show you in the flesh, so to speak. My sister and I went to a store about 40 minutes away from me, 20 minutes away from her, that is generally a quilting and a yarn store, but there was some threads, and they had some specialty threads. So I popped in to have a little look-see. They had some kits too, but they were so expensive. It's like, I think it's cheaper somewhere else. And I know that's bad because, like, supporting your local and everything. But, yeah, nah, I wasn't going to do that. So I bought four from this place. But I can only show you three because one is for a gift. So I'm going to just pop that back in the bag. So two were from Cottage Garden Threads. I purchased 410, which is Blue Wren, which is so pretty. And by the way, these are my first like hand dyes that I've ever purchased. So I'm excited to use them. And I also bought 1606, which is butterfly, which is just cute. Love that. Now, I did get another one, which was from my sister. Maybe she bought me butterfly. I don't remember. I don't know where it is. I think it's in my cupboard. I forgot to get it, but that's okay. There was another one from this brand, but anyway. So they're those two. And then the last one I bought from that store was a Valdani. I need to learn how to speak. And it's called Orange Blossom. Now that's not coming through quite as bright. It's not as pastel-y as that showing it. Okay. That's what that is. I love orange. It's my favourite colour. So I wanted to get an orange one. That was my favourite in the whole store. And then on my trip away with my girl family, we went to, and it was a bit disappointing because I was under the impression that we were going to an L&S, which we were, and we did go. The first time we went to, I knew was a yarn store. So there was nothing else but yarn there, which was really cool. There was a lot of pretty stuff. I tried a knit and it's just not my thing. So I was like interested for everyone else, but it wasn't really my thing. So once they were all finished, we went next door to a cafe and had lunch, and that was nice. But that store had another store, like a franchise of it, almost. They're owned by the same people in just a town about 15 minutes away. So we went to that. And that on their website said quilting, knitting, cross-stitch, embroidery, needlework. So I was like, oh, cross-stitch, there's going to be something there for me to get, like some patterns or something like that. We get there. I was like, okay. And on the left, there was yarn, like lots of yarn. On the right, there was just a whole bunch of different quilting supplies and everything. I was like, cool, cool. So I was expecting like maybe some like linen or Aida, some kits, some patterns or some threads and things like that. So we're walking through and the walls are just covered in quilting fabric or just fabric in general. There was just so much fabric and they had a 50% off sale. So it was really cool. So much fabric. We're walking through. I walk around like the whole store. I see some kits on near the back on this big stand thing. I'm like, awesome. Looking through and it's all embroidery. I was like, okay. So they clearly have kits, but I need to find the cross-stitch one. So heaps of embroidery, heaps of embroidery. I found the DMC rack, which was like pushed right in the back corner, which was so weird, but that was all there. And I was like, well, I don't need any DMC, so I'm going to move away because they were like a dollar something each anyway. So I didn't bother with that. And then I found these two threads, which are by Wildflowers by Caron. Now these were 50% off, so it was pretty good. But this one, I don't think it even has a, oh, I can't say that word. Scheherazade. That's that. It's got some orange and purples and blue, like grey blue in there. So that was really pretty. That's the tag. And then I also bought this one, which is Ocean Breeze. So the other one, sorry, was 184 and this one is 181. Now that looks so blue, but it's actually a minty green, like quite a bright minty green. That's it there as well. So I've purchased those two. And well, I picked them up and I was walking around the store and I kind of just got so disheartened because I went and asked the lady at the counter for some linen or Aida and she looked at me funny and I was like, oh, that's not good. And I said, do you have any linen or Aida for cross stitch? And she goes, oh yeah, we've got some. And it's like, awesome. And then she takes me down to this like little, tiny little corner of this place that I completely missed. And it was like a whole bunch of Aida. And it was either this color or this color. I was like, oh, I don't really need it. Like I was really hoping for some hand dyes. So I kind of was a bit sad. I got those threads and that was okay. And then the next day we went to another store, which again, it said, it was called like, I don't remember what it was called, but it said, actually no, at this store with these threads, sorry, I'm going off on tangent. There was some cross-stitch patterns right at the counter in this dingy ass box. So I'm looking through it and there was some cute things, but it was like nothing really exciting, which was a bit sad. Then we went to this other place at a different town that apparently used to have a lot of cross-stitch, but it's going into a quilting store. And there was like one cross-stitch kit there, which was really not my thing. So that was really, really disappointing. So around me, I haven't yet to find any L&S type of places, and I don't think I will. It's just not something that's as prevalent here. So that's really sad. But anyway, I've got online to get me through. Anywho, so they're those specialty threads that I bought on my little weekend away. So I, as you know, purchased some Soda Stitch patterns for my birthday. And I had sent them to Adele, who I talked about before, to send to me because it was cheaper postage. So I'll talk you through those few that I bought. The first one is the Princess Collection. With who have we got? We've got Snow White, Rapunzel, The Little Mermaid, Cinderella, Aladdin, and Sleeping Beauty. No Belle, which is so weird, but hey, I showed my sister and she didn't like it because there was no Belle, but whatever, it's still cute. And it's like a book, guys, so just fair warning, it's not the smallest thing in the world. I'll quickly do this. It is colored though, so it's really pretty. There's that one. The next one I purchased was Four Seasons Dogs, which, if you know me, I'm obsessed with dogs, so I couldn't say no to that one. It also has a alphabet type of thing on the back if you wanted to write something like that underneath it with the summer, spring, summer, what is it? Summer, spring, summer, fall, winter. Except for me, it would be summer, autumn, winter, spring. But anyway, so that's really cute. Love that. And then the last one I purchased was the World Collection, which is just all of these ladies in their traditional costumes from their countries. This is also a book, I'm pretty sure. Yes, but it is smaller. No, actually no, it's a springy, it's pulled out. So that's cool. Lots of different ways to do that. And I love this one a lot. When I saw it, I was like, yeah, that's my next one. So I got those. And then in the package, Adele had given me, oh, hang on. You know what I found? This is the one my sister bought me from that store. It's called Poppy 600. Anyway, that's off topic. She gave me some Jovelin, 28 count Jovelin to practice on because she's the sweetest little thing in the whole world. And it's by Paul Stitches Designs, hand-dyed fabrics. I think it's called Awakening. Kind of say it smells really nice. It looks like those. And it's much brighter than it's showing up there, but it's gorgeous. I don't know if it helps if I do this. Oh, yeah, kind of. It's a bit bright on that side. So pretty. So many things I've just shown you could go in there. So that's cool. Now, I don't remember if Adele sent me anything else. I don't think she did, but she always sends like the cutest packages. And by the way, Adele, I do have your return package to send, but I haven't had time. But now I'm on holidays. On Monday, I'm going to send you it. And it's got a nice, delicious surprise. Let me just say that. Spoilers for you, Adele. Now, Adele is my Stitch from Stash 2017, a postcard pal, if anyone's wondering why we send each other stuff. Plus, we're just awesome. Not going to lie. Now, next thing is I got my Geeky Stitch & Co. box for the month of February, I think. I think so. Got some Ada, as always. She sends out supply packages, and that was one of them. There was also a skein of floss, but I put it away and I don't remember which one it is. This month, sorry about the Russell. The theme was marshmallows. Now the full kit. Which one is the full kit? Oh no, I can't remember. Ah, I think it's this one. You make me feel gooey. It's so cute. I love it a lot. Now that one comes with a thread, Ada, a needle, and also the hoop. So that's what you get in a Geeky Stitch & Co. box. You get a full kit. You also get the Ada and the skein of floss. And you get two other patterns. This one says fries before guys. Heck yes! Give me them fries. And squad goals. Kind of morbid, but I kind of like it. It's like squad goals, but we're going to die. That's bit far, Laura. Anyway, so that's my February box. March should be here soon. Now, it comes to me quite late, as you can tell, because it's a UK box and I'm in Australia. So it comes to me about, it's close to a month after she sends it. So I have a subscription to Cross Stitch Crazy magazine, the UK one, and I received two magazines for some reason since I last saw you. I think it was just one might have been late and the other one was at normal time. So I've got April and May. So here's April. In April, there was also this free kit for Mother's Day. It's like a little card with a cat, I guess. Now, I want to check. Sorry, my laptop keeps turning off. I think this has the pattern in here. Now, I don't enjoy cats, and I don't think my mum would like this. So I am thinking I might make some form of giveaway to do with this. Just wait till the end, because there's something else as well. So, cross-stitch crazy. Now, I'm not going to lie, didn't particularly, this is the main, that's really cute, but it's not really my thing. Didn't particularly love this issue. Not because anything's really changed, it's just that I wasn't really feeling anything, you could say. This one I like. This is my happy place. So I've got, excuse me, itchy nose. stitching stuff. That's really cute. Again, not sure if I'd stitch it because I've got that much to stitch. Like, I get these. It's crazy for stuff, but why sushi? Let me know if you stitch some sushi because that's pretty cool. I just don't. There's a pretty alphabet to do with baking, but I'm just double checking if there's something that I miss. Some musical instruments, Easter eggs, random patterns. Yeah, no, this one wasn't my fave. Not because I hate everything. It just wasn't my thing. There's that one. Then there was May, and in May was this kit. It came with a frame and everything, which is pretty. Not sure if or when I would do this, so it might go with this. This one was pretty okay. There was definitely one thing in here that I love, which I'm 100% going to show you. Now there's the butterfly. This is the main one. And these are cute. I just don't want to stitch them. That sounds really bad. It's just not my thing. I clearly have a style, and that's not it. Where is it? Fruit and veg. I'm going to stitch some fruit and veg. Here it is. I love this. How cool are these animals? There's a lion, a wolf, and a fox. Danielle, there's a geometric fox. Oh my god. It's so cool. I love these. I'd love to stitch that lion. It's just beautiful. And the wolf is pretty cute too. They were my favourite thing in this magazine. I remember that for sure. There's a whole thing to do with tea. I don't drink tea, so that's really awkward. There's a wedding sampler in here too, which is nice. It's just a bunch of flowers. Some more alphabets. There's like a big Vespa thing. Scooter. Again, not my thing. I feel like a bad person for saying these things. I just don't like them. There's some cute get better cards because we're all getting sick, which is fair enough. So, yeah, my favourite thing was definitely the animals here. I don't think I'd stitch anything else in here. And to be honest, I'm probably not going to resubscribe to this just because the past, like, 3 or 4 issues have had nothing that I like in them. Not nothing that I like, but nothing that's like, oh, I must stitch this now. After my year is up, which I think is in near July, I'm probably just going to go through them, take out the stuff that I want, and then either give them to my family and friends or stash on load for free, because I'm not going to get someone to pay for like a ripped out magazine. If it's full, I might like put a couple dollars on it, but nothing crazy. Okay. Ah. Oh. Mum also bought me a Thread Heaven. Never used one. And she uses it for every single thread that she uses. And she was like weirded out that I didn't do it when she bought it for me. But I don't really need it. With the DMC for me is fine. She uses it for everything. But she uses a lot of kits. So I'm thinking that maybe the floss in there is not the best. But I would use this for something like a metallic or a annoying thread or something like that, but I need to not lose this because it's so small. I need to put it beside my stitching spot. Anyway, next exciting thing is that I received my Nora Corbett. For those that remember, this is my birthday gift for my grandma and my grandpa, or granny and pa, who, granny did come on the trip and she loved it. She had such a good time. So here it is. This is Ophelia's Pearl by Nora Corbett. I'm obsessed with it and I cannot wait to start it. It's so beautiful. All around here is, and there's heaps of beads up in here. But it's not crazy, like it's, there's only 3 packets of beads, which to me is like not the worst. For my first kind of Nora Corbett or mirror, I wanted to do something smaller, so I chose this. Excuse me. I've got all the DMC in here. I just bought it all. I didn't want to look through what I already had. I just purchased everything. I'll show you the beads. BDB beads. These are all Mill Hill glass seed beads. We've got 165. Let's cover my face. There we go. 2004 and 2096. So we've got like oranges, pinks, and reds. I'm obsessed with these colours. I love them. Now, I purchased a different fabric to the recommended. This is 32 count Jobelin Summer Sky. And I don't know what kind of brand it is or who. Anyway. So, it's a little bit bluer than it's showing up, but it is like a bluey white fabric. And I'm obsessed. It's so cute. It's such a gorgeous colour, and like, let me just lean it against myself. Like, these colours are going to look just the best on there. So, I love it. Mum helped me pick this out on the website on 123, and we were kind of thinking that it almost looks like the ocean a little bit, like the reflection of the sun and stuff, so I can't wait to start this, and I'll let you know when I'm starting it in my plans, which is coming up. So don't click away. I should be on TV, quite clearly. Oh dear. Sorry, everyone. That's my really awkward humour coming into play, but we're all a bit weird, aren't we? Okay. Now, exciting news. I signed up to Fabric of the Month Club. And I'm so excited by it. excuse me. I chose Colour Cascade, sorry, I'm already getting it wrong, because she's based in Perth and I'm in Victoria, so it's not that far away. I am using my leftover, because I actually had leftover birthday money, which is crazy, to pay for the first couple of months for this, so it's not coming out of my Citrum stash. And then from there, it will come out. I think it'll be April, 2 months I'll have to pay, which is fine. I'm getting enough finishes and everything throughout the months to be able to do that. I'm quite a bit over my budget, which is really cool. So I received March on Friday, which is so exciting. I'm choosing 32 count Jobelin because I like even weave. I've not used linen, but from what I can tell, I would not like it because of the way the stitches lay and stuff. I like a bit of even, because I've only ever come from Ada, so I'm thinking even weave is like the best kind of alternative. So yeah, 32 count Jobelin plain, not opalescent, and it's 18 by 26, and this month was Forbidden Fruit, and it's gorgeous. It's very, very pink. Look at that. Oh my God, it's beautiful. It is pretty true to what's coming up. It's a little bit darker, I think. It's like this pinky, corally, watermelony colour. I'm just loving it. I've no idea what I'm going to stitch on this yet because I've recently got it and nothing is really entering my mind until the holidays is over, but it's gorgeous. I'm so excited. It's my first piece of hand dye that I've bought myself. And I didn't even choose it, and I'm obsessed. So I love this idea of a mystery fabric because I'm so like picky and not picky, but I get really worried about the colours and things when I buy stuff online. I just get a bit worried about the colours and things online, and it takes me forever to choose something. So to just have something come to my door, I don't have a choice. It's probably something I wouldn't have purchased. Like, I wouldn't have purchased Forbidden Fruit because, oh my god, it's so pink, but it's gorgeous. So I'm very excited about it, as you can tell. I'm already at 41 minutes. What the hell? It's okay. We're nearly at the end. That's the end of my haul. So that'll be coming every month. I'm just going to double check I've done everything. I have. Clearly, I haven't made a video in a while, and I haven't been able to talk as long because I've been home alone to do these videos for a while. So I'm very excited. Let's talk about plans. There's two more sections, plans and then something else, and then we'll be done, all right? Just calm down, please. So my first bit of plans I want to talk about is my BAPS, my big ass project. So as you guys know, I've got Pokemon on the go, and I've also got a Hade happening. Now my Hade is Mini Clockwork Dragonling. I'll put a picture up here if I can find it or if I don't forget. So last time you saw me, I'd finished a page of Hade, of my Hade, and it is a mini. So there's, I think there's 12 pages of her. It's not the biggest full coverage in the world. Pokemon is 25 pages, but I think the pages are smaller. And after I started, you know, being at school and stuff, I just realized that I wouldn't be giving the amount of time that I would like to into my big project. So I've decided that for the foreseeable future, my Hade is going on hiatus until I finish Pokemon. I know. I told Adele and she said, well, we're not going to see that for 3 years. And I said, you're not wrong. But I want to give Pokemon its fair chance because it was my first BAP. It's my first one I've started and my first full coverage. And I want to give it the attention it deserves. So I'm going to, that's why I'm trying to smash out these two pages now in the school holidays. Or as much as I can, if it's more than two pages. Heck yeah, that's awesome. So that's what I want to do with my BAPS. I'm going to give it its time. And then if I get sick of it, sure, I might swap over. But I'm not, like I wasn't going to, but again, I'm not starting any more full coverage pieces until they're both done. Because I don't know why I did that. I should have saved my Hade. I really should have. But you live and you learn. So it'll be Pokemon. When that's done, I'll go on to my Mini Clockwork Dragonling. And then from there, I'm going to do Rapunzel. Because I've got most of the stuff for Rapunzel. Thanks to the person who gifted me everything. I'm not going to say your name because I still haven't asked if I can do that, which is annoying. Yeah, so that's going to happen. I'm going to try and give Pokemon a fair bit of attention over the next, you know, however many months and years or whatever. But that's not going to happen until after May, and I will tell you why very soon. Rest of April, let's talk about it. So as I've said like 400 times, Pokemon until I go back to school. I go back to school on the 16th. Oh, let me just check. Sorry if you're moving. I'm just opening the calendar on here. No, it's the 18th of April. Haha. But as she flips over her book, I'm doing Jessie Marie's sale like everyone else. But that's okay. I'm really excited to do it. So let me talk you through, have I already talked about this? I hope I haven't, because that's really awkward if I have. I feel like I've talked about it with my boyfriend, and I've posted it on the Facebook group. I don't know if I've even talked about it, but who cares? I skip it if I have, okay? So, it goes like this. It goes from the 15th to the 26th of April. Her birthday's on the 25th, and then there's one on the 26th. So, 15th is Oldest Whip, which is Pokemon, so I'll be working on that anyway. The 16th is something to do with D, J, M, or S. Danny and... Is it Danny? I hope it is. Danny and Jessie Marie Sats, which is their names. And I'll be doing The Mermaid for M. So that's when I'm starting Ophelia's Pearl, and I'm so excited. So I'm starting that on the 16th. 17th is something you've been enabled to do, Mermaid, again. I'm repeating a lot of things, just so you know. Mermaid again, because I've been watching people do pretty things like that for ages, and now it's my turn. 18 is to do with favourite colours, so maroon, orange, or purple. Obviously Mermaid, she's got that much orange in her, smashing her out. 19th is animals or bonus points if it's a bulldog. Nothing to do with bulldogs, unfortunately. Not even dogs. So I'm just going to work on Pokemon because they are technically animals. 20 is something pretty, so mermaid. 21 is something difficult or something to do with a diamond. So I think I'm going to just do, I don't know for that one. I'm probably going to do my mermaid because I feel like it might be a little bit difficult. Plus there's shiny things. So that could be like a diamond. 22 is close to finish. And I don't know what my closest finish will be. It'll either be a page finish on Pokemon or it will be a Fearless Pearl. I'm assuming it'll be Pokemon, but we'll see. Then on the 23rd, I'm going to have a new start, as it is 29, because she's turning 29. And I had nothing that kind of related to 29, and I'm starting the Marauders map, pop it up here, by Clouds Factory. And I solemnly swear I'm up to no good, it's 31 letters. So I was like, you know what, I'm going to just do that for 29. 24 is bookish, so obviously Marauders map. 25 is new start, recent start, birth, something to do with birthday. Awesome, because new start, yes, recent, yes, and I bought this with my birthday money, so Marauders map again. And then 26 will also be the Marauders map. So that'll get 4 days work. 26, by the way, is family, and I'm choosing to do Marauders map because not only is Harry Potter a big thing in my family, but I purchased it with birthday money from my family. Why not? So they're my plans for that part of April. So that leaves the 27th to the 30th. And I haven't decided what I'm going to do for those few days. It'll be a focus piece. So it will either be a Fearless Pearl or Marauder's Map. Marauder's Map isn't huge, but it is a little bit fiddly. So I'm guessing that I will be close-ish to finishing that at that point after the 4 days. Let me open my calendar again. Yeah, some of those days are over the weekend and a public holiday, so I will have a fair bit of time. I'm guessing I'll be doing Marauder's Map. We'll see. Then in May, I will talk about this further in my next update video, but I am doing Stitch Mania. I am doing some new starts, but I'm not doing like 15 or 30. I've got 5 starts, but I need to work it out first before I talk about it again. So they're my April plans. I'm super excited for this sale because I haven't done a sale since the Christmas one that Stitch Mania did. This 12 Days of Christmas. So I'm excited to switch it around. Even though it is only 3 projects, I'm still giving each one a fair bit of time. After Mania, because I'm not going to be working on Ophelia's Pearl during May, from what I can tell at this point. After Mania, I'll be going back to her. I'm thinking, but I will talk about that next time. Lastly, to finish off the video, which is almost an hour, which will be my longest video, I'm wanting to do a giveaway, if you couldn't tell. I'm getting close to 500 subscribers on my 500 followers on my Instagram, and I've got 400 something on here, so I thought, why not, let's just do something. Plus I'd finish something that I wanted to give away, so I'm still don't know how I'm going to do this. Maybe I'll do 2. We'll see. So the first one I'm going to give away is Luck Bears, because I don't need it anymore. I want to give it to someone. You've seen what it looks like finished. I'm going to do this. Kind of looks like this. Now, I will let you know it is used. So it does have like a white strip down there. I did also rip this bottom here. Okay, but it's not huge. But this was my working copy, but I didn't highlight anything. That's what I'm trying to say. I used this, but I didn't highlight anything. So I'll pop it into an envelope and send it to you. So that's the first giveaway, and let's just do this. Second giveaway is these 2 kits. I think I'm gonna have to open up the... Okay, so what I'll do is I will cut out because the patterns are in the magazines, and I'm obviously not gonna use them, so I'll cut out the pattern and give it to you as well. So that's these 2. Honestly, I won't be surprised if nobody enters for these 2. But you might love them, and that's okay. Because they are, like, I'm not going to lie, they are cute. They are cute things to do. I just won't do them. That's it. So, to enter, let's think of something fun, which won't happen because I should have thought about this before. Let me know, this is number 1, and these are number 2. Okay, so this is number 2, these are number 1. This is number 1, this is number 2. Okay? I want you to tell me either or both that you'd like to enter into. Try and keep it as un-giveaway-ish as possible. Like people say, don't mention giveaway. Maybe just say number one or two or both. And then make sure that your comment, because you can do this, has hashtag Star Wars pajamas, because I'm wearing Star Wars pajamas. I'll put it on the screen. That's really complicated. Can we do that? Let's just try it. If it doesn't work, I'll just scroll through the comments. So put number one or number two, hashtag Star Wars pajamas or Star Wars PJs. Let's make that easier. Star Wars PJs. Hashtag Star Wars PJs. Yep, let's do that. So just put number one or number two or both. For example, hey, Laura, number one looks cool. Hashtag Star Wars pajamas. PJs. There you go. Then I'll know you want to be entered. I probably won't get anyone entering for this, but that's okay. We just do what we do. This was a mess of a video, but you know what? It's my life, so it's fine. I hope you've enjoyed listening to me ramble for close to an hour. I don't usually post long videos, so hopefully you can find a fair bit of time in your day to sit down and watch me. That's weird. I'm going to go and do some Pokemon soon. I think I might have some food first. Mm-hmm. And then do some Pokemon for the rest of the day and watch FlushTube because I'm trying to catch up. Wishing everyone all the best in April. Hoping you get so much smashed out. I'm hoping I do too. I look forward to watching your update videos and your any type of FlushTube videos because I'm trying to get caught up and find new people and blah, blah, blah. But it's tough. Any questions or comments, leave them down below. Remember, number one on number two, hashtag Star Wars PJs for the giveaway. And I'm sorry I haven't replied to any comments of my last video yet. I am planning to do it over the holidays. It's just not the first thing on my mind after work. I just want to sit. It's actually a biological thing, but we can talk about that another time. Have a wonderful stitching April, and I will see you again at the end of April, start of May, for my next update video with hopefully heaps of progress on my new projects. Love you guys so much, and I'll see you soon. Bye!